Now let us look at the following theorems. The first one is the redundant literal rule. It says if we have A plus A complement B, it can be written as A plus B, right? And if we have A dot A complement plus B, it can be written as AB. So there are two ways of proving this kind of theorems. Either we can use the Venn diagram to prove this theorem, or we can use the switching algebra expressions to prove this theorem, or we can make a truth table for this. So what I will do is I will try to prove these theorems with the help of the truth table. Okay, so the first theorem is the redundant literal rule. It says if we have A plus A complement B, it can be written as A plus B. Let us try to make a truth table for this. We have A, we have B. Let us try to find A complement, then we'll try to find what is A complement B, then we will try to find what is A plus A complement B. Okay, so what are the combinations? They can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So what is A complement? A complement can be written as 1, 1, 0, 0. What is A complement B? That means we have to make AND of these two, A complement and B. So their AND will be 0, 1, 0 and 0. And then what is A plus A complement B? That means you will going to apply OR between these two. So the OR will be 0, 1, 1, 1. This is 0, 1, 1, 1. Now if we make A plus B, so assume this is A, this is B, and this is A plus B. Right, so their combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Then A or B is 0, 1, 1, 1. Right, so as you can see, this and this both are same. So we can say left hand side is equal to right hand side, hence proven. Right, so we can also visualize this with the help of a Venn diagram. So how can you visualize it with the help of a Venn diagram? Assume this is a universe. This is denoting A. This is denoting B. Okay, then what is A? So A is this much. This complete is A. This complete is A, right? And then what is A complement B? A complement B is the part of B which is not in A. So this is the part of B which is not in A, right? Right? So, and then what is A plus B? A plus B is basically adding this part with this part, right? So as you can see, if it is A plus A complement B, then obviously it is equal to A plus B with the help of this diagram, right? So it is a very simple thing to prove, right? So next is A dot A complement plus B is equal to AB. As you can see, this is just a dual form of this, but still we can try to prove it. So you can see here, if we take A, assume this is A, this is B, then their combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. And let us try to find what is A complement. So A complement can be 1, 1, 0, 0. Sorry, it is 1, 1, 0, 0. I should not have written it here. And then what is A complement plus B? A complement plus B is 1, 1, 0, 1. And then what is A dot A complement plus B, right? So you have to make AND of between these two, AND between these two, okay? So AND will be, this is 0, 0, 0, 1, right? And let us try to find AB. What is AB? If this is A, this is B, and this is A dot B, then AB is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and this is an AND operation. Therefore, we can say it is 0001. So as you can see, this value, this and this both are actually equal. Correct? So you can see we have just proved the redundant little rule. Now let us try to prove the absorption law after this. Now let us try to prove the absorption law. So what is the absorption law? It says if we have A plus A dot B, then it can be written as A, right? So there are two ways. Either you can prove it using Venn diagram. So let us try to draw a Venn diagram. This is a universe. Assume this is A, this is B, right? So what is A dot B? This region is denoting A dot B. So we can say we are selecting this region and we are selecting the complete A, right? As you can see, this is just covering the complete A. So we can say A plus A dot B is equal to A. It is very simple to visualize this way. But let us try to prove it using the truth table. So we have A and B, and this is A dot B. We can say what is AB? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. A dot B will be 0, 0, 0, 1. And then what is A plus A dot B? That means we are doing OR between this and this. So OR will be 0, 1, 1, 1. Right? Sorry, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. So which is actually equivalent to A itself. Right? So we can say the absorption law holds in this case. So next is A. The next part of absorption law is A dot A plus B, which is equal to A itself. This is just a dual form of this, as you can see. So we can say in this case, if this is A and this is B, right? So the combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Then what is A plus B? A plus B can be written as 0, 1, 1, 1. And then what is A dot A plus B? It can be written as, so we can say it is 0, 0, 1, 1. So which is equal to A itself, right? Therefore, you can say the absorption flow holds in this case also, correct? Now let us try to prove the consensus theorem after this. Next is the consensus theorem. So what is the consensus theorem? It says if we have A, it says if we have AB plus A complement C plus BC, it can be written as AB plus A complement C, right? So we can prove it using the truth table, but that will be a very long method. But instead of that, we can just use identities of switching its algebra for this. So this is the left hand side, LHS, and this is the right hand side, RHS. Now let us take the LHS. This is left hand side. So it is AB plus A complement C plus BC, right? So how can you prove it? We have to make this left hand side equal to right hand side. So you can say it is AB plus A complement C plus BC dot A plus A complement, right? So which is equal to 1, right? So you can say it is very simple to understand. Why I'm doing this? Because if you see, BC is equal to BC dot 1, right? So B dot C is equal to BC dot 1. And instead of this one, I can also write BC is equal to BC dot A plus A complement. It is very easy to understand in this case, right? So you can write it as AB plus A complement C plus ABC plus A complement BC, right? Now between these two, this one and this one, you can take AB as common. Between this one and this one, you can take A complement C as common. So it will be AB, which is 1 plus C plus A complement C, which is 1 plus B. So it is equal to 1 itself, it is equal to 1, right? So we already know this. If you do A plus 1 or one expression plus 1, then it is equal to 1 itself, because OR is going to make it as 1. So it can be written as AB plus A complement C, which is equal to the right hand side. Hence, the consensus theorem is proved. right? So this is, you can say, this is just a dual form of the consensus theorem. So let us try to prove it. So it says it is A plus B dot A complement plus C dot B plus C is equal to A plus B dot A complement plus C, right? So this is the left hand side, this is the left hand side, and this is the right hand side. So let us try to make left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So LHS is A plus B dot A complement plus C dot B plus C. Try to expand it, so it will be A dot A complement plus AC plus B dot A complement plus BC dot B plus C, right? So it can be written as 0. So it is 0 plus AC plus B dot A complement plus BC dot B plus C, right? So you can eliminate it. So it can be written as, try to expand it again. So it is ABC plus B dot A complement plus B dot C plus A dot C plus A complement B dot C plus B dot C. So you can say it is equal to B, this one. Here again it is repeating itself. Here again it is repeating itself. Here again it is repeating itself. So it can be written as ABC plus A complement B plus BC plus AC plus A complement BC plus BC. It is very simple to understand. So from this you can take something as common. Take this one and this one. You can take BC as common. So it is A plus 1, right? Take this one and this one. You can take A complement B as common. So take A complement B as common. So it is 1 plus C, right? Plus we have AC, right? Plus one more thing. If it is repeating itself, it is BC plus BC, then you don't have to write it twice. You can just write it once, right? So there's no benefit of writing it twice. So we can take it as, you can just add it. We'll check it later on. So BC, so this is 1, this is 1, so it is BC plus BC plus A complement B plus AC, and this is equal to BC itself. So it is BC plus A complement B plus AC. It is very simple to understand in this case, right? Now let us take the right hand side. So right hand side is, what is the right hand side? It is RHS is A plus B dot A complement plus C. It can be written as A dot A complement plus A dot C plus B dot A complement plus BC, which is equal to, this is 0, so it is AC plus A complement B plus BC, right? So here also we are getting AC A complement B plus BC, here also AC A complement B plus BC, right? So the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So this consensus theorem is also true. Now let us try to prove the transposition theorem. So let us prove the transposition theorem. It says we have AB plus A complement C. It can be written as A plus C dot A complement plus B, right? So let us try to prove it. Let us take the left, we have the left hand side and the right hand side. Let us try to take the right hand side first. We have right hand side. It says A plus C dot A complement plus B. So it can be written as A dot A complement plus AB plus A complement dot C plus BC, which is equal to, this is equal to 0. So it is AB plus A complement C plus BC, right? So this is the right hand side. Fine. Now let us take, with this BC I can write AB plus A complement C plus BC A plus A complement. So it can be written as AB plus A complement C plus ABC plus A complement BC, right? So in this case we need AB and A complement C. So you can take AB as common between these two. and A complement C is common between these two. So it will be AB into 1 plus C plus A complement C into 1 plus dot 1 plus B. So it can be written as AB plus A complement C. As you can see, this can be written as 1 and this can be written as 1. So it is very easy to understand. Fine. So now let us try to prove more theorems in this case. So let us take the first expression here, try to note the questions before solving it. So it says reduce this expression. Now we can write this expression like this. This is a brackets b plus c complement, here ab plus ac complement whole complement, right? So let us try to solve this one first. So it is a b plus c complement, it can be written as ab complement plus ac complement, so dot ac complement, right? So it can be written as a b plus c complement, further a complement plus b complement dot a complement plus c complement complement, right? So it can be written as c only. So try to solve it. B plus C complement, taking expanding the bracket, so it is A complement dot A complement plus A complement C plus B complement A complement plus B complement C. So further, B plus C complement, it is A complement plus A complement C plus A complement plus B complement C, right? So now expand this, so it is B plus A complement C complement plus A complement C dot C complement plus A complement B complement plus B complement C dot C complement, right? So it can be written as 0, it can be written as 0. So the expression will be A B plus A complement C complement plus A complement B complement only, right? So it can be written as A dot B plus A dot A complement C complement plus A dot A complement B complement, right? So it can be written as 0, it can be written as 0. So it is A dot B plus 0 dot C complement plus 0 dot B complement. This complete is 0 and this complete is 0. So it can be written as AB only. Fine. So you can reduce this expression to complete AB. Now let us try to solve the next question. In the previous session, we have solved the first question. Now let us try to solve the second question. It says, if we have the function which is f is equal to a plus b dot ac plus b plus c complement d, we have to reduce this expression. So let us try to open this bracket. So we'll get a plus b ac plus bd plus c complement d, right? So again, try to open the brackets. A plus abc plus b dot bd plus b dot c complement d. Now you can take a as common between these two, so you'll get a 1 plus bc plus bd plus bc complement d, right? So here this expression will become 1, so it is a plus bd plus bc complement d. Again, between these two expressions you can take bd as common, so it will be a plus bd 1 plus c complement, which can be written as a plus bd, right? So this above function can be minimized to a plus bd. Now let us try to solve the next question here. So it is, the function is a plus VC whole complement dot AB complement plus ABC, right? So let us apply De Morgan's law here. So it will be A complement dot BC complement dot AB complement plus ABC. So it can be done as A complement dot BC, and here you can say, you can take A as common, so it will be B complement plus BC. It is A complement dot BC. It is A. You can distribute B over here. So B will be B complement plus B dot B complement plus C. So this can be written as 1. So this expression can be written as A complement dot BC, A dot B complement plus C. Now you can open these brackets, so it can be written as A complement dot A dot BC, B complement plus C, right? So you can see here, we have A complement dot A. So as you can see, as you know, we can associate the bracket, so it can also be written as A complement dot A dot BC dot B complement plus C, and this can be written as 0. So it is 0 dot BC B complement plus C, and which makes the whole expression as 0, right? So this complete expression can be minimized to 0 in this case. Okay, now let us take the next question. So next question is, the function is f is equal to b plus bc dot b plus b complement c dot b plus d, right? So first of all, let us try to take b as common between these two. So you'll get 1 plus c dot, you can distribute b over here, so it is b plus b complement dot b plus c. Here we have b plus d. So this can be written as, this is 1 plus c, which is equal to 1. So it is b dot, this can be written as 1, b plus c dot b plus d. Fine. So it can be written as b dot b plus bc, b plus d. Further, it can be written as b dot b dot b plus b dot d plus b dot c plus c dot d. So this is only b, this is bd, this is bc, this is bc and d. So here we have b plus bd plus bc plus bcd. You can take b as common between all of them, so it is b dot 1 plus d plus c plus cd. So as you can see here, we have 1 as or 1 is or between these terms, so it is b dot 1, which is equal to b itself. So this whole expression can be minimized to b. So next question is, show that if we have ab, we have to show that if we have ab plus ab complement c plus BC complement, it is equal to AC plus BC complement, right? So we have to show this left hand side is equal to this right hand side. Okay, so you can even say, so it is, take the left hand side first, so it is AB plus AB complement C plus BC complement, right? And here we have AC plus BC complement. Let us try to take A as common between these two. So it will be B plus B complement C plus BC complement. Distribute B over here. So it is A, which is B plus B complement dot B plus C plus BC complement. And this is equal to 1. So it is A 1 dot B plus C plus BC complement, which is equal to AB plus AC plus BC complement, which is AB plus AC plus BC complement, right? Now you can take, for this expression you can take A, B, C plus C complement plus AC plus BC complement. So it can be written as ABC plus ABC complement plus AC plus BC complement. Between these two expressions you can take BC as common. Between these two expressions you can take AC as common. So this expression can be written like this also. So it is ABS, take AB as common between this and take AC as common between this and this. So it will be, if you take AC as common, so it can be written as B plus 1 plus, if you take BC complement as common, so it can be written as A plus 1. Further, this is equal to 1 and this is equal to 1, so it can be written as AC plus BC complement, right? So hence left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we have proved that this expression both are actually equivalent to each other. Now let us take the next question. Next question says, show that AB complement C plus B plus BD complement plus ABD complement plus A complement C is equal to BC, right? So we have this left hand side, which is equal to A B complement C plus B plus BD complement plus ABD complement plus A complement C, right? So we have to prove that this left hand side is equal to B plus C, right? So here you can see already have B. We have to remove, we have to eliminate all these expressions to get C. So you can just write B in the beginning. So plus you can say we have A B complement C plus BD complement plus AB D complement plus A complement C. In this expression you can take BD complement as common between these two. So it can be written as AB complement C plus take BD complement as common. So it is 1 plus A complement C. And this is equal to 1 itself. So it can be written as B plus AB complement C plus BD complement plus A complement C. Take C as common between these two. So it can be written as AB complement plus A complement dot C plus BD complement. So which is B plus, distribute A over this. So it is A plus A complement dot B complement plus A complement dot C plus BD complement. And this is equal to 1. So it is B plus A complement C plus B complement C plus BD complement. Now take B as common between these two. So you can take 1 plus D complement plus A complement C plus BC DC. So which is equal to 1. So it is B plus A complement C plus B complement C. Now in this expression you are not having B, so you can take B, or you can just do one thing, it's very simple, distribute B over this. So we can say we'll get B plus B complement dot B plus C plus A complement C. We have just distributed B over this, so we'll get, this is equal to 1, so it is B plus C plus A complement C. So you can take C as common between these two, so it is B plus C, 1 plus A complement, which is equal to B plus C itself, right? So we have seen, we have proved that left hand side is equal to right hand side, this complete expression is equal to B plus C. So the last question says, simplify A plus B dot A plus C complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. So it is A plus B dot A plus C complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. So we have to simplify this expression, right? So do one thing initially, but you can start by either you can expand any one of them and you can open these brackets. So well, first of all we'll do step by step, open these brackets. So it is A dot A plus A dot C complement plus AB plus BC complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. So it can be written as A plus AC complement plus AB plus BC complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. You can take A as common between these two, or better way is take A as common between these three. So if you take A as common, so it is 1 plus C complement plus B plus BC complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. So this complete is 1. So it can be written as A plus BC complement plus A complement B complement plus A complement C complement. Now you can take any one of these two expressions. Let us say this expression is not having C, right? Or better way is to distribute A between this and A with this. So let us distribute A with this. So it can be written as A plus A complement dot A plus B complement plus BC complement plus A complement C complement. Further, it can be written as 1. So it is A plus B complement plus BC complement plus A complement C complement. Now you can distribute A over this and you can distribute B over this. So it can be written as A plus A complement dot A plus C complement plus B complement plus B dot B complement plus C complement. Further, this can be written as 1, so it is A plus C complement. This can be written as 1, so it is B complement plus C complement. And C complement and C complement both are same. So it can be written as A plus B complement plus C complement. Right? It is very simple to understand in this case. Now let us look at this question. They are saying, define the connective star for two valued variables A, B and C as follows. A star B is equal to AB plus A complement B complement, and let C is equal to A star B. They are saying C is equal to A star B. Now determine which of the following is valid. First is A is equal to B star C, B is equal to A star C, A star B star C is equal to 1. They are asking which of the following is valid. Okay. So let us, first of all, we know what is C. C can be written as A star B, which is equal to AB plus A complement B complement. They have already given this. If we take C complement, then it can be written as A star B whole complement, which is AB plus A complement B complement whole complement, which can be, you can apply De Morgan's law on this. So if you apply De Morgan's law, you can say it is AB complement dot A complement B complement whole complement. Further, you can expand it, so it can be written as A complement plus B complement dot, here also you can expand it, so it can be written as A plus B whole complement complement, which is equal to A complement plus B complement dot AB. Now if you open these brackets, so it can be written like this: A complement dot A plus A complement dot B plus B complement dot A plus B complement dot B. And you know what is A complement dot A and what is B complement dot B. This is equal to 0 and this is also equal to 0. So it can be written as A complement dot B plus B complement dot A. So this is C complement. Okay. So I am finding C and C complement initially because these values I will be utilizing while I will be solving this question. Okay. So first part is, they are saying prove that which of the following is valid. So first part is, they are saying A is equal to B star C. A is equal to B star C. Is it valid or not? Okay. So this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Let us take the right hand side first, RHS. Right hand side is B star C. And here they are using a star operator, hence it can be written as B dot C plus B complement dot C complement. Now you know why I have already calculated what is C and C complement. I can just put these values over there. So if I put these values, it can be written as B dot AB plus A complement B complement, which is the value of C, plus B complement dot, and the value of C complement is A complement B plus AB complement. So further, it can be written like this, open the brackets, A dot B dot B plus A complement dot B complement dot B plus A complement dot B complement plus A B complement dot B complement. So it can be written as AB plus, here you take, we have B complement dot B which is equal to 0. So it is A complement dot 0 plus, here you can we have B dot B complement which is equal to 0. So it can be written as A complement dot 0 plus A B complement. Further, it can be written as AB plus AB complement plus 0 plus 0. You can take A as common between these two. So it is A B plus B complement which is equal to A dot 1 which is equal to A, and this is equal to the left hand side of this question. So you can say this one is valid. The first one is valid. Now let us take the second one. Second one is saying we have B is equal to A star C. B is equal to A star C. Is it valid or not? Let us take the right hand side. This is the right hand side. Right hand side says we have A star C. So it can be expanded like this. A dot C plus A complement dot C complement. And you know what is the value of C and C complement? Put these values here. So it can be written as A dot AB plus A complement B complement plus A complement dot A complement B plus AB complement. Further, it can also be written like this. We have A dot B plus A dot A complement dot B complement plus A complement dot B plus A dot B complement. It is equal to AB. This is 0. So it is plus B complement dot 0 plus this is equal to A complement dot B plus this is equal to 0. So it is B complement dot 0, which is equal to AB plus A complement B plus 0 plus 0. Further, you can take B as common between these two. So it can be written as A plus A complement, which is equal to B dot 1, which is equal to B itself. Hence, the option, this second part is also valid. This is also valid. Now let us take the third part. Third part is saying, this one maybe might be tricky as compared to the previous one. So it is saying we have A star B star C is equal to 1. A star B star C is equal to 1. So now let us take the left hand side here in this case. Left hand side. It is saying we have A star B star C. You can associate according to your preference, but let us say I'm going to expand this one first, B star C. Just for example, okay. So there is no associativity defined in this case. So I'm just going to expand this one first. So it is A star. What is B star C? Or yes, there's one more. There's a better way of writing this, right? So let me just do it again. We already know that A star B is AB plus A complement B complement, and C can be written as A star B, right? And here in this case. We already have A star B. So it can also be written like this. It is C star C. So if we have C star C, now put these values into this. So we will get C dot C plus C complement dot C complement, which is equal to C plus C complement, which is equal to 1. So it is one of the most easiest one, right?
Fine. So now let us take few more examples of these kind of questions, and then we'll move on to what are functional properties in case of digital logic, or you can say in case of switching algebra.